Hello everybody, welcome to the Kenny Hack. For this video we're going to be going over how to make a quick photoshopped piece of what your customers send you for a photo, and that you can send them kind of an approximation of what they're going to be purchasing. If you're like me, you can put out into the marketplaces some examples of your work and you might get thousands of views. But most people, I kind of feel, are reluctant to make a purchase when they don't exactly know how their photos are going to turn out and kind of what they're going to be getting. So if you can provide them with some quick kind of simulated views of what they're going to buy, it seems like they're a lot more ready to make a purchase when you can show them what they're going to get. So that's what we're going to be going over. For this video, I'm doing all my editing on my phone. I prefer to use my phone because I can do my editing anytime I'm free during the day to do it. For this one, I'm going to be using Background Eraser and Photo Layers. Those are the two main programs I use. You can use any other program that you feel you're most proficient in with creating multiple layers of photographs and manipulating them layers to get a desired effect. I've been photoshopping on my phone for a number of years, so it's just what I'm most comfortable with, how I can do it the fastest, and it's ease of availability that I can do it any time of day when I get free time. So that's how I'm going to be showing in this tutorial. The first thing you're going to want to do is get a photograph of one of your typical slabs of wood that you use. You're going to want to get a photograph where the background is a fairly uniform color, such as this, where it's all white, so it's easy to delete out in the photo editing software. From here, I'm going to start deleting out that white background around the outside of the slab, and that is going to be your first step in editing your background masks. This is going to be done on multiple layers, but once you have all your layers created, you'll be able to apply the same masks to any of your clients' photos they send you very quickly and very efficiently once you get used to it, to be able to send them a good idea of what they're going to be getting. Now, all this editing that's being shown is shown in real time. This is not sped up at all. This is about as fast as, once you get pretty proficient with using these programs, this is how fast you can erase out backgrounds, erase layers, and create layers to be able to help Photoshop images further down the road. And once they're built, you can use them multiple times. There's no need to keep doing this every time. You'll be able to use the same layers for any client that contacts you. So as you see, I was deleting out the background. The magic button does a very good job at trimming it right to the dark edges. But sometimes it overshoots, sometimes it undershoots, it doesn't get all of it. And so that's here. I'm going back in, cleaning out the spots that it missed, going to the repair button, filling back in the spots that it erased that I didn't want erased. And then once that's all fixed, it's ready to save and we'll move on to the next spot. So now we'll be going to Photo Layers and we'll be applying that background deleted slab over a generic background image that I just found off the internet. Trimmed it down just to something that looks a little more home decor-ish, just to help the clients get a better understanding of something that looks a little closer to what it might look like in their homes. So this is the generic background image I picked, and I already photoshopped it down and cropped it down to kind of put my slab into the view. So I save that as the background. I imported in my slab, and I just selected it to fit. I didn't trim it down at all, just select it to fit if you don't want to move it around. So I saved that image, and then we'll be applying some Photoshops to that image and creating more masks to be applied later. So this first mask, I'm going to be deleting out to the farthest edge of the top surface. This will be used to simulate if the laser burn was going all the way out to the edge. Now, if you've ever burnt these live edge slabs, that very outer edge, if it's not masked off, burns a very dark black. It burns very easy. And some people might like that burnt edge. Some people might like to have the more natural light brown wood. So we're creating a mask for each layer. So the first, we're just going to start on the very outside one, and we're going to work our way in, creating a couple different masks to show different options to the clients of what they can get, whether they want the burnt edge or whether they want the lighter natural look that would require the edge being masked off. Once again, this is all being shown real time. This isn't sped up. This is as fast as I can edit an image. And it doesn't need to be exactly perfect. You're making quick Photoshops just so the client has some idea what they're getting. This is all we're trying to do for them. This is the long part of the process, is creating these masks. So that was the first mask created. The next one is exact same process, but we're moving the mask to the next layer inward. We're going to be cropping out the image, leaving in the darker brown ring on the live edge. Now this will be your second option for these live edge slabs, is either to have a blackened edge, or you can mask off with masking tape, cover up this darker edge so that it doesn't burn and it creates a different look. One of them will have a very dark pronounced edge, one of them is a little more natural looking, and it might be up to the client whether which style they like. So it's just something else. If you can give them two options, they'll feel it's more personalized to what they want, and that once again they'll be maybe more willing to make the purchase and feel that it's more custom to exactly what they want. You'll see me several times in these videos switching the background color from the dark background to the light background. That just helps you identify if you skipped any little patches of work and that you need to go back and edit it out and fix it. Now we'll be going back into photo layers and bring in all these different masks that we've created plus your client's portrait, and I'll show you how to layer them so you can kind of create the illusion that it's been lasered onto the slab. First, bring in your layer that had the outermost photo cropping. The next layer will be the second image, and you just select it to fit. And then the third layer will be just the original slab. Once again, just select it to fit. As you can see, since nothing was moved around, everything was selected to fit on the original background, everything snapped into place. Nothing had to be moved around or resized. That's why it's important not to change. Just select everything to fit. From here, we're going to be bringing in the client's photo. I have selected a photo that somewhat looks like a wedding photo. It's actually Star Wars, and if you watch my channel, you know I'm a Star Wars nerd. So right now, the image is the top layer. Everything below it is on layers beneath it, so it's in the background. Now we'll bring in the layers I created before, except now there'll be a layers above, so it'll mask out the edges of the portrait. So it'll appear that the portrait has been placed onto the slab. That's the illusion we're trying to create. So here I'm bringing in the layer that has the natural brown edge and created a mask over the image. And as you can see now it appears that it's all cropped in onto the slab. And you can play around, you can kind of play with your centering. Once you have it centered, now you can start trying to manipulate the image to make it look more like a laser burned image. And from that, you just go over to the color adjustments and you can start playing around. You'll have to learn what each one of them does. Normally, you bring your opacity down. You're trying to make the wood grain from behind kind of come out a little bit. You want to be able to see the wood grain come through, because on a real image, you're always going to see the wood grain. From here, you're either going to want to start playing with the images, color and opacity, brightness, contrast, or you can also play with just the slab image that's right below it. You can increase its contrast, brightness, saturation. Just play around until you learn what each setting does, and you can slowly get to where you're seeing the wood grain underneath and that it's starting to look more and more like a burned image. And that's all we're trying to create here. And right there, I'd call that a pretty close finished image. I'll post a link at the end, a picture of what the final image looks like, so it's a little easier to see with more of a close-up. It's pretty hard to see on this pulled back screen. So I'd have saved this image. About two screens in, after you hit save, it'll say image saved. But just don't click on finish. You can hit the back arrow and come back to this screen and keep manipulating to make your next view. So the next view you can provide is what it would look like if the laser burnt all the way out to the edge. So here I'm taking the mask that has the natural brown edge and I've shifted it to a darker image just to simulate it that it's burnt. And then I'll apply the first mask that has the outermost edge on it so that it kind of covers up all the background that got shifted black. And you'll see what I'm talking about. See right there, it restored all the background but left that lighter brown natural edge black. So this is the second image you could provide to your client. Now to go on ahead and save this image. Now this process can be repeated with any kind of slab shape that you use, whether it be a square slab or a really elongated slab. Make masks of the typical shapes that you use that you can give your client more options to pick from. And that should really help increase your sales. The client wants to feel they're getting something that is truly custom work. Here are a close-up of the two finished products. You can see the wood grain through it. It looks kind of like a wood burn. It's typical colors that are achieved, at least with my process and how I feel my images turn out. I hope this has been a good use for you, maybe help increase your sales. Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, share. See everybody on the next video.